Inflation affects us all. We certainly hear about it often and feel it year over year when we go to the supermarket as the cost of living goes up. What I don't fully understand, and many of you might not understand, is how are the inflation numbers calculated? Well, let's find out. Welcome to Economics Made Simple. In order to help us explain, I'd like to introduce you to Clint Dahl. Clint, we keep hearing about these inflation numbers, but people don't know what it actually means. Can you explain to us how inflation gets calculated?
I'd be happy to explain. And after I break everything down, you'll understand how simple it really is. Inflation is defined as a decrease in the purchasing power of money, reflected in a general increase in the prices of goods and services in an economy. The question I'll be answering today is, how is it measured? Inflation is measured by CPI, or Consumer Price Index. Consumer Price Index is a measure of the average change over time in the prices paid by consumers for a market basket of consumer goods and services. What goes into the basket is determined by the Bureau of Labor Statistics and covers a variety of different sectors. These include energy, utilities, food and beverages, housing, apparel, transportation, medical care, recreation, education and communications, and other goods and services. The index then tracks the change of the price of this basket each month. Changes can be calculated month to month or year over year. We can use CPI to calculate the long-term change in the price of goods and services. For example, in 1975, $10,000 would have gotten you a specific basket of goods and services. By 2018, that same basket would have cost around $46,000. This is why a challenge for many savers is keeping up with the cost of inflation. If you were to just take your money and put it under your mattress, your money would lose value in the form of purchasing power every year at the rate of inflation. CPI is an important economic indicator because, first of all, it's used to calculate inflation-adjusted payments for things like Social Security. And most importantly, it represents the increasing cost of everything we purchase in our lives. Thank you, and I hope after watching today, you understand a little bit more about inflation.
Thank you, Clint. That was simple. Today, we learned about the inflation numbers, but we've got so much more to teach you about the economy in future episodes. Be sure to subscribe to this channel to learn more.
Joe Montana here. Click subscribe now and hit the notification bell to stay up to date. You'll be glad you did.